So welcome back. We would be focusing on MCQs related to environment and ecology today. Most of the topics that we would be covering are from the contemporary section. So let's begin with our very first section of 10 questions here. Now the first question talks about the statement on Innovation Mission 2.0. Which of the following statements in relation to the given statement are correct? So we have four statements that are given and you have to identify which of the following statements are correct. As always, we do have surprise prizes for those attempting the correct answer. So looking for the first correct answer, Grisha, please mention the question number along with the correct answers. Now the various statements that are given here are talking about the Innovation Mission 2.0. It was launched by DST and it was announced in 15th November on the guidelines of the Paris Agreement, the Paris Climate Agreement. Then we have, great, so Altaf already has the first correct answer. Now here we need to understand that this is an initiative not of 36 countries but 24 nations along with European Union. The idea is to provide global clean energy innovation and then National Solar Mission would increase the solar capacity in India. So 2 is the incorrect option, 1, 3 and 4 are the right answers. Monica, Sahiti again has the right answer, great. So let's move to the next question here. The next question focuses on the State of Environment Report, a very, very important question for this time. The State of Environment Report 2021, what are the findings for it? Every time this is a very important topic, one of the most important sections that we have already covered in the Down to Earth edition. So here, we have the various options and the first correct answer for this question would receive a special gift from our side. So looking for the correct answers for question number 2. The State for Environment Report 2021 is released by whom? The organization that releases it is famous for what? What has been the India's rank and which has been the most populated cluster? Among these, you have to identify only the incorrect statements, not the correct statement. So just take the question very, very carefully. It's the incorrect statement only. So looking for the right answers for question number 2, as I mentioned, this is a surprise question. We would have one further surprise question later. Now here, this report has been released by Center for Science and Environment, CSE. CSE is a public interest research organization and a advocacy organization. So 1 and 2 are the correct statements. According to the CSE report, Tarapur in Maharashtra is the most populated cluster. India ranked 117 among the 192 nations in terms of sustainable development. So only 3 is the incorrect option. So C is the right answer in this case. Okay, so all those with correct answer, kindly send in your details to admin@examrace.com. Let's move to the next question. The next question talks about coelacanth. Now, coelacanth is another important topic, very, very important this time. The fossils of coelacanth, which is a giant fish, has been regarded as iconic example of living fossil and therefore is important. And in this question, we have to find out the correct statements. These fossils are nearly 66 million years old and there are 2 known species of coelacanth. Now, the statement 3 says there is only 1 known species. So definitely there is a controversy between 3 and 4. We need to understand where the statement goes wrong. And here we understand that there are 2 known species. One is found in the waters off the coast of Sulawesi Island in Indonesia. The other is near the Comoros Island in the east of Africa. So it's not only one. Read the statement very carefully. It's not just only one species. There are two species, one of which is at Comoros Island in Africa. The other is at Sulawesi Island in Indonesia. So third statement is incorrect here. 1, 2, and 4 are the right statements. I hope that's clear. Okay, coming on next, we have with respect to Asian water bird census, which of the following statements are incorrect? Now again, read the question carefully. Which of the statements are not correct? You have to focus on that. Now, we have the following statements. Question number 4, again, question which asks on incorrect statement. So looking for right answers for question number 4. The Asian water bird census. Now first of all, this question focuses on Asian water bird census. So the citizen science program is the Asian water bird census. Okay, thousands of volunteers from Asia and Australasia are part of it. It was initiated in 1987, not in the Sri Lankan region, but in the Indian region. Okay, Indian subcontinent. So Sri Lankan subcontinent is the wrong content that is given here. And the count gives not only an idea of the number of the birds at the wetland, but also the health of the birds. So 4 and 3 are the incorrect options. 1 and 2 are the correct options. I hope that's clear. Okay, so 1 and 2 are the right options. Since it asks about 3 and incorrect, so 3 and 4 would be the incorrect options. Coming on next, we have which of the following statements about green tax are correct? Okay, so which of the statements are about green tax are correct? Now, green tax is imposed on older vehicles. The idea was to reduce the pollution levels. The tax would be levied by Ministry of Road and Transports and Highways. Again, correct. Gayatri, please mention the question number with the answer so that we know on which question we are. Public vehicle transports will have to pay a green tax. So, the statement 3 is wrong. Again, vehicles with strong hybrid electric vehicles would not have to pay the green tax. They would be exempted from the green tax. So again, 4th is incorrect. So in this statement, we have 1 and 2 as the only correct answer. So 1 and 2 would be the right option for this question. Okay, so A would be the right answer. I hope that makes sense. Let's move on to the next question here. The next question focuses on India's draft Arctic policy and which of the following statements are incorrect regarding the India's new draft Arctic policy. Now, India's Arctic draft policy focuses on expansion of science and technology and exploration of oil and gas in the Arctic region. The idea is to provide more scientific study, more explorations and more tourisms in the Arctic region. So, the first statement says that India has drafted a policy for expanding scientific research, sustainable tourism and exploration. That's correct. Promoting Arctic tourism is one of the major objectives. So it's not just promoting Arctic tourism, which is one of the major objectives. Okay. Arctic is the subpolar region in the southern part. It's a polar region, not a subpolar region. So the third statement is incorrect here. The next is focusing on. So Arctic is a polar area in the northern area, so that is correct. So promoting Arctic tourism is one of the objectives, but the new Arctic draft policy aims at the scientific research, sustainable development and exploration of oil and gas in the Arctic region. Sorry, I just missed this. This is written Antarctic here, so this becomes incorrect. So please do not repeat the silly mistakes that I did right now. So first statement is incorrect. It's not the Antarctic. So I just incorrectly read it as Arctic. So it's Antarctic. Okay, so first statement and third statement are the incorrect statements. Second and fourth are the correct statements. Since it's asked about incorrect, we have D as the right option. I hope that's clear. Okay, let's come on to the next question. The next question focuses on biomedical waste. Now, this is a very, very important topic. Get to know all about the biomedical waste this time. Very, very important, the bifurcations, the red, yellow, blue categorization, the four categories of biomedical waste. We have already covered one of the videos on the channel as well. Very, very important topic, I repeat for this time. So, among these, which of the following is the correct statement? Okay. Now, here we have non-segregation of waste results in incineration of contaminated plastic. That is correct. Since we are not able to segregate the waste, we have to incinerate, that is burn, the contaminated plastic. The biomedical waste have been categorized into four categories. Again, correct. Used gloves are put in red colored bags. And we have given, well, when we have explained the lecture on biomedical waste, we have talked about the colors and the codings. The land for setting up the common biomedical waste treatment is provided by the state government. So again, 2 is incorrect. So 2 and 4 are the incorrect statements. We have 1 and 3, that is B. Rohit, Sahiti, Altaf, Shiromani, a lot with correct answers. So the correct answer here is B. Great. The next question that we have is, The next question that we have is about seed bombing, a very, very important topic again this time. To rejuvenate, revegetate or do reforestation, which of the following things have been used? And this is one of the methods which is known as seed bombing. Now here, seed bomb is a little ball which is used for revegetation and reforestation. It can be a composite of compost, clay and seeds. Aerial seeding is the method which is done. So seeds are just thrown and sprayed using the aerial devices, and this has been employed recently in the city of Udaipur in Rajasthan. The idea is to increase the forest cover and not in the region of Jharkhand. So 4 is the incorrect option here. The correct answer, the correct statement here would be Udaipur in Rajasthan. So 1, 2 and 3 are the correct answers here. So the incorrect statement is only 4. D is the incorrect statement. I hope that makes it clear. So Shashank has the right answer. Great going, Shashank. Great Big Bang, you are from Udaipur. Okay, so let's move on to next question, which focuses on another very important topic, which is Dhole conservation. Now this is again a surprise question. Looking for the first correct answer for this question, question number 9, please mention question number along with the correct answer. The correct answer for question number 9 would receive a special gift from our side. So simply mention your answer and your postal address to admin@examrace.com. Question number 9, Dhole conservation, looking for the correct answer. And here note that the given statement says which of the following is correct. It does not say incorrect, it says correct. Okay, so refer this question very, very carefully. Now, Dhole is a wild carnivorous animal and it is mainly seen in the regions of Central Southeast Asia and Southeast Asia. It belongs to the canine family. It is also known as the Asian wild dog. And in India, it is predominantly found in Maharashtra, Madhya Pradesh and not Odisha but Karnataka, where the conservation has been ranked to the level of being endangered and therefore is important. The first breeding conservation center for Dhole was created in 2014. So first and second are the correct answers for this question, and therefore we have A as the right option. All those who have marked A as the right answer, please send in your complete postal address to admin@examrace.com. Coming on to the last question for today, which is about Madhuka Diplostemon. Which of the following statements are correct regarding this? The question says which of the following statements are not correct but incorrect regarding this. Okay, so we have to identify question number 10. What is this species about? Whether it is a tree, whether it is an animal. Sahithi, we need to know the incorrect option. So just go back to the question and have a revisit on the question again. So Madhuka Diplostemon is a tree which has been rediscovered in the Kollam areas in Kerala. It is locally known as Kavilip in Malayalam. So both first and second are correct. Then the tree has been identified by the scientist from the Jawaharlal Nehru Institute at Palod in Kerala, not Sri Lanka. So the third statement is incorrect. It's the scientist from Palod in Kerala. And the tree is to be is included in the IUCN endangered list. So again, this is incorrect. So 3 and 4 are the incorrect statements. 1 and 2 are the correct statements. So this was about the basic questions from the section on environment and ecology that we have covered. Next week we would meet again at the same time, and we would be covering topics related to science and technology. Since there were numerous questions from science and technology last year, we would have a comprehensive focus on those again. And as I mentioned, we would be having a series of expected topics that would be released before your prelims examination in October. So stay tuned for probably a weekly list of important questions, expected questions for your UPSC that we would be releasing. Till then, study well. We would be also meeting this Saturday with a special topic on employee verification. See you on Saturday at 6 p.m. Have a wonderful evening ahead.